Hi everyone, today I am going to discuss about the medical surgical nursing for the GNM second years, and that is unit 9, nursing management of patient with the musculoskeletal disorders. So in the last class we have seen about the amputation, that is part 1, and today is part 2 about the amputation. So it is the part 2 of the amputation. So up to the types and diagnostic evaluation we have seen in the part 1, and in the part 2 we are going to discuss about the levels of amputation. So levels of amputation, it can be determined by the circulation in the part and functional use of limb. So the levels of amputation means after the amputation there is a circulation to the affected area and there is a functional use of limb. So how much we are using the limb, and we can it can be determined by the levels of amputation. So there is a levels of amputation, it includes the partial foot amputation. So partial foot amputation means there is an amputation of lower limb distal to the ankle joint. So the partial foot amputation means half of the foot fingers can be removed by the amputation. In the partial foot amputation, from the distal to the ankle joint, so ankle joint, so from the ankle joint to the fingers, so from the fingers, so the fingers can be removed in the partial foot amputation. Only half of the foot can be removed, so up to the fingers, and the fingers can be removed by the amputation in the partial foot amputation. And the next one is transdorsal amputation. So in the transdorsal amputation, it includes the dorsal bones. So from the dorsal bones up to the fingers, there is a removed by the amputation. In the transdorsal amputation, from the dorsals to the fingers can be removed by the amputation in the transdorsal amputation. So next one is the ankle disarticulation. So ankle disarticulation means up to the ankle joint, total foot is removed by the amputation in the ankle disarticulation. So the amputation in the ankle disarticulation, there is an ankle joint can be removed. From the ankle to the total foot has to be removed in the ankle disarticulation. And next one is transtibial amputation. So the transtibial amputation, the amputation of the lower limb between the knee joint and the ankle joint. So the amputation, the limb has to be removed from the knee joint to the ankle joint. So between that, the amputation can be done. So between the knee joint and the ankle joint, and between that, the limb has to be removed by the amputation. So in the transtibial amputation. And next one is knee disarticulation. So in the knee disarticulation, up to the knee joint, total limb has to be removed. Up to the knee joint, the limb has to be removed in the knee disarticulation. And next one is transfemoral amputation. So transfemoral amputation, the amputation can be done between the hip point and the knee joint. So from the knee joint to the hip joint, so middle part of this, and it can be removed by the amputation in the transfemoral amputation. So between the hip joint and the knee joint, so between that, the leg has to be, the limb has to be removed in the transfemoral amputation. So next one is hip disarticulation. So hip disarticulation means there is a amputation of limb at the hip joint. So the pelvis has to be remaining like that only, and the hip joint, up to the hip joint, and the limb has to be removed. So the pelvis become intact. So the pelvis become remaining kept like that only, and up to the hip joint, the limb has to be removed in the hip disarticulation. And the next one is transpelvic amputation. So there is a transpelvic amputation, there is an amputation of whole lower limb. So there is a half of the pelvis has to be removed in the transpelvic amputation, and the whole limb has to be removed, and half of the pelvic part has to be removed in the transpelvic amputation. And next one is the partial hand amputation. So in the partial hand amputation, there is a half of the fingers, so up to the fingers, partial half, partially hand amputation means there is in the wrist hand only half of the fingers can be removed in the partial hand amputation. So in the partial hand amputation, only half of the fingers can be removed in the partial hand amputation. So next one is wrist disarticulation. So up to the wrist, so this is the wrist, and up to the wrist it should be removed in the wrist disarticulation. So up to the wrist and the hand should be removed by the amputation in the wrist disarticulation. Next one is transradial amputation. So transradial amputation means there is a amputation of the upper limb between the elbow joint and the wrist joint. So it is the elbow joint and it is the wrist joint. So between these, the limb has to be removed in the transradial amputation. So transradial amputation means the amputation of the upper extremity between the elbow joint and the wrist joint. So between this and the limb has to be removed in the transradial amputation. And next one is elbow disarticulation. So in the elbow disarticulation, up to the elbow, so this is the elbow, up to the elbow the limb has to be removed, and it is called as elbow disarticulation. So next one is transhumeral amputation. In the transhumeral amputation, the amputation can be done between the elbow joint to the shoulder joint. So from the elbow joint and there is a shoulder joint, between that the limb has to be removed. So it is called as transhumeral amputation. And next one is shoulder disarticulation. So shoulder disarticulation means up to the shoulder the limb has to be removed. So this is the shoulder, and up to this the limb has to be removed. It is called as shoulder disarticulation. And next one is four quarter amputation. So in the four quarter amputation, the amputation of the upper limb at the scapulothoracic. So at the back side, there is a scapula will be present and the sternoclavicular joint. So from the sternoclavicular joint to scapula, the limb has to be removed in the four quarter amputation. So it is about the levels of the amputation. And next one is preoperative management. So in the preoperative management, there is a hemodynamic evaluation is performed through the testing. So there is a circulation is present to the affected part or not, we can identify by the some test like angiography. And next one is culture and sensitivity. So the culture and sensitivity can be performed if the patient having any infection, and what are the organisms can be present in this, and we can identify by the culture and sensitivity. And next one is level of evaluation of the cardiovascular system and renal system and respiratory system. So before the surgery, before the amputation, the nurse has to be assessed for the cardiovascular system, and there is a respiratory system and the renal system. And next one is nutritional status. So the before the surgery, before the surgery, the nurse has to be assess the nutritional status. So because now the healthy diet, it can be helps to for the early healing. So the nurse has to be assessed for the nutritional status. And next one is exercises. So the exercises can be limited to the affected part, and it can be improves the muscle strength. So by the exercises we can improve the muscle strength. Now next one is provide emotional support. So the because of the amputation, because the loss of the limb, the patient may become depressed. So we can provide the emotional support to the patient. So by the emotional support we should provide to the patient. So next one is post-operative. So after the operation, the nurse has to be provide the some of the care. First, assess the neurovascular status. So the neurovascular status. So the nurse has to be assessed for the any edema. So any inflammation is present at the surgical site or any bleeding is present, and the nurse has to be assessed. And next one is affected area is immobilized. So which is amputated part that is become immobilized. So there is no movement can be present in the affected part. Next one is hemorrhage and the shock. So the nurse has to be assessed for the complications like hemorrhage, means there is a bleeding is present at the surgical site, or the nurse has to be assessed. And there is a shock. So because of severe blood loss, the patient may undergo shock. So shock means there is a decreased supply of oxygen or blood flow to the organs. So there is a and the nurse has to be assessed for the hemorrhage and shock. Next one is complications. So the nurse has to be assessed for the complications like bleeding and shock. So the nurse has to be assessed for everything, and there is a positioning and elevation of the stump. So positioning is very important after the operation of the 24 to 48 hours. And elevation of stump. So stump means there is a after cutting of the limb, so the remaining part is present, it is called as stump. So the after removal of the limb and the remaining part is present, it is called as stump. So the part should be elevated up to the 24 to 48 hours of the surgery. So it is about the post operative management. So next one is nursing management. So the nursing management includes the nurse has to be assessed for the pain of the patient. So according to that pain, and the nurse has to be administered the medications as prescribed by the physician. So according to the physician order, the nurse has to be provide the medications to relieve from the pain. And next one is assess for the blood loss. So at the surgical site, the bleeding is present or not, the nurse has to be assessed. And the control edema and dressing. So if the patient having any swelling, so the nurse has to be assessed for the swelling, and the nurse has to be clean the area and by the dressing. So by during the dressing, the nurse has to be maintain the aseptic techniques to prevent the infection. So daily the nurse has to be do the dressing for the affected area. Next one is encourage for exercises. So to improve the muscle strength, the nurse has to be encouraged for the exercises. So it is about the nursing management for the amputation. Thank you.